Well, welcome to our program. This is Miss Rowe's first grade class, and we are performing the musical program, The Little Red Hen. One of our narrators is absent today, so Sammy, your narrator, our first narrator, is going to do both parts. So thank you so much for doing that. So I hope you enjoy the show.
Once upon a time, there was a little hen who lived on a big farm. She had several fluffy yellow chicks and, as you see, lots of animal friends. One morning, as the little red hen was scratching around the barnyard, she uncovered some grain of wheat. Excited at her big discovery, she called out to her friends and neighbors, saying, So the little red hen planted the seeds all by herself.
What a lovely day to plant my
After many days of beautiful sunshine and nights of soft rain, the wheat began to grow. Thank you. wheat began to grow and grow and grow and grow. Rowe pulled the tall golden grain. She called out to her friends and neighbors, saying, so the red hen reaped the wheat all by herself.
Well, the lovely day to reap the wheat.
Very carefully, she cut the wheat and tied it into bundles. The next day, it was time to take the wheat to the mill so it could be ground into flour. Eagerly, she called out to her friends and neighbors, saying,
if we take this to the mill, we will certainly have.
So the red hen trotted off to the mill with her large bundles of grain. In a few hours, she was back home in the barnyard with a lovely sack of fine flour. By this time, the little red hen and her chicks were quite hungry.
We're hungry!
Anxiously, she called out to her friends and neighbors, saying,
when we turn this flour into bread, we will have meals for days ahead.
So the red hen rolled out the dough all by herself, nodding what a lovely day to roll out the dough and bake some bread. She kneaded it with care and rolled out with the dough, formed a loaf, and carefully placed it into the oven. Before long, animals began to gather as they smelled the delicious smell of baking bread. And Laura had busied herself setting her table with plates, glasses, napkins, silver, and fresh butter.
Now maybe I will get a little bit of milk with my bread. Maybe she has some crackers too. Come on, move over. Now let's not have a hissy fit.
When the bread was baked to a perfect gold brown, the Little Hen and her chick sat down. As they were about to enjoy a special feast, the Little Hen noticed all of her barnyard friends and neighbors. She smiled sweetly, turned to them, and read a poem. Animals hung their heads in shame. The Little Hen was right. They didn't deserve any reward, as I didn't do anything right. The Little Hen truly believed that each of the animals had learned an important lesson. After gathering them together, she made room for each and every one of them around her table. And the next time somebody thinks to ask, I hope you'll help them do the task. In the meantime, take a seat and share the goodness that comes from